So let me define what is called as a semi-ring. So given any set X, a family of subsets of X which is denoted with the letter S is called a semi-ring if it satisfies the following three properties. Firstly, empty set should always belong to S. And second, if E and F are two sets that belong to S, then E intersection F should also belong to S. And finally, the third condition is that if you have two sets E, F which belong to S, and consider E minus F, the set difference of E from F, then you should be able to find some sets C1, C2, so on till CN, such that C1 union C2 union so on till CN is nothing but E minus F. Or in other words, you can write the set difference E minus F as union I is equal to 1 to N CI. And not just that, CI intersection CJ is empty whenever I is not equal to J. Therefore, in summary, what is a semi-ring? Given any set X, a family of subsets of X which we denote with S is called a semi-ring if the empty set belongs to S, whenever E, F belong to S, E intersection F also belongs to S, and finally, whenever two sets E and F belong to S, the set difference can be written as a union, finite union of disjoint sets of S. Let us now look at an example for semi-ring. So consider the set S which contains all the intervals of the form AB where A is strictly less than B and A, B are real numbers. So therefore S is a family of subsets from R. Therefore from above notation we are taking X to be R. Then we need to show that S is a semi-ring, or we have to check that S is a semi-ring. For that, first we need to see if the empty set belongs to S. Now, clearly empty set does not belong to S because whenever A is strictly less than B implies there exists some point C which is a real number such that A sits in between A and B. Therefore, it cannot happen that no interval A, B is non-empty for any real numbers AB. Therefore, now we have the interval A, closed A, open B is non-empty. But we require that the empty set belongs to S for S to be a semi-ring. Therefore, what we can simply do is simply include phi in this set. Therefore, when I include the empty set as an element of S, by definition phi belongs to S, therefore this part of it we need not check. Therefore now by definition phi belongs to S. Now to check the property 2, let E and F be two sets in S, then E is of the form a comma b for some real numbers a and b, and F is of the form c comma d for some real numbers c and d. Therefore E intersection F is either phi E F or some interval of the form k1 comma k2, where k1 and k2 are real numbers. Therefore in all of these cases E intersection F belongs to S. S satisfies property 2 as well. Finally consider for property 3, two intervals open A, closed A open B and closed C open D in S. Then their difference can be either empty set or closed A open B or some interval of the form closed k1 open k2, where k1 and k2 are real numbers, and again all of these three are again members of S. The difference between these two intervals closed A open B and closed C open D, since lies inside S itself, it can be represented as a finite union of members in S. Therefore in conclusion, S is a semi-ring.